Because I don't recall this time clearly that I am about to share with you has been a puzzle pieced together with the help of my wife and others who were involved during the 4 weeks of my life that I spent under the care of the health care workers whose God-given talents, wisdom, and skills saved my life. Early in the morning at 4 a.m. on Thursday, November 22nd, 2018, my life and the lives of those who loved me changed. I don't recall this myself, but I collapsed at home and was unresponsive. Joyce called an ambulance to take me to the hospital. I was unable to respond to anyone as infection raced through my blood. Joyce called my family and Pastor Douglas, and prayers were requested. My family and MP community, church family, responded, providing comfort and assurance. But more importantly, many prayers were said, and I know that God's presence was there. I believe God places people in the right place, the right time, and the right day. I believe this because late Friday, a nurse was with me at the exact moment my heart stopped beating. Without a pause, she, alone with 9 other hospital staff, diligently worked for 8 minutes and 9 seconds to keep my heart beating while my family, friends, and others prayed. The nurse, who called an angel sent by God, fought for me in a battle I could not have won. God put her in the right place at the right time, and she saved my life until the heart started to beat on its own. On Sunday, Pastor Douglas came with Joyce, family, Everton, and Juliana to my bedside. While I could not speak, I lay there weakly. Pastor Douglas assured them that a battle was going on. With a stone like this, each person was gathered around me, and the Pastor Douglas gave one stone that he had taken from the valley where David, in faith, faced Goliath, a giant, and was victorious. He reminded them that God will fight for us even when we cannot fight for ourselves, when the odds are overwhelming. I was then anointed in faith that the words of Isaiah 10:27 might be fulfilled with this, that this burden shall be taken away. I cannot remember which of this time, but one of the things I can recall was that that touch was real. 4 weeks passed before I was able to come home, 3 days before Christmas. I was thankful to be home. Through God's grace and prayers of many people, my body was restored. No damage was done to the heart, and I was able to recover with minor adjustments. But the peace was given to my family because of the promise that, yea, though I walk through the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. God fought that battle for me, even though I was lay helpless, though through many promises claimed by my family and many prayer warriors, through their faith in God, I was given another chance. My life was changed. It has taken me a little while longer to understand that God not only wanted to heal my body, He wanted to heal my spiritual life as well. My trust and relationship in Him has grown stronger through His love shown to me.